Shalom Aleichem and welcome to Online Smicha. We all know the famous story of Dambud ben Nissina and how the lesson and the halachas we learned from a story that happened with this guy. And perhaps when you delve a little more into the story, you see that that little story is not only mentioned in Gemara Kedushin as a lesson for one very famous halacha, it teaches us so many more halachas. Now, the Gemara is a Masechta Kedushin, where the Gemara says, Ad heichon kibud aveim. How far does a person have to go and show honor and respect? How much does a person have to invest of his money, of his time, to fulfill the mitzvah of kibud aveim? And we know the very famous story. So Rav Elazar responded and said, Amar lahem, he said this Talmidim, Tzu'u u'u, let me show you, listen to me. Ma asa oive kechavim echad la'aviv. I want to share with you a story that a Gentile, a guy, did with his father in Ashkelon. And this Gentile is not, he shared a name, V'damo ben Nissina Shmoy. And his name is Damo ben Nissina. And from him, we could learn, from a guy called Damo ben Nissina, we could learn how much a person has to invest time or energy or money to fulfill a mitzvah of kibud aveim. What's the story of Damo ben Nissina? Pam achas, bikshu mimenu avonim le'efod. The Chachamim knew that he had precious stones, and they wanted to buy from him a special stone to have for the Kohen Gadol, for the Ephod. And they were really willing to give him shishim ribui schar. Shishim ribui schar is $600,000, a lot of money for a jewel. And other Afkahana says it wasn't shishim ribui, it was even more. They were willing to offer him shmeinim riboy, $800,000, a crazy amount of money for a jewel. That would have been a business deal of a century for him. But they came to visit him. The keys to the chest of where the jewel was, the keys was under his father's head, and his father took a nap, and his father he had to get the key, and he said, "V'loit sierra." He didn't wake him up he was willing to pass. He was willing to lose a business deal of the century, a being not to wake his father up. And the Masechta Kedushin, Daf Lamed Aleph, that's a mucker, that's the answer, as I mentioned before, to the how far, look, we can learn from a havdol, from a guy, how much a person has to do to fulfill the mitzvah of kibud aveim. The same story is brought in the Masechta Avodah Zarah. And over there, we have other lessons that you can learn from that. First of all, the Gemara discusses there if you're allowed to take donations from a guy, or things that belong to a guy, could they be transferred and to elevate it to the Beis HaMikdash? Because after all, the Pasuk says, V'yikhu li truma, and the Gemara, according to one opinion, held that all the things that were used as a truma for the Beis HaMikdash has to be bought from a yid. And here the Gemara challenges it with a story. They went to Damo ben Nissina and tried to negotiate to buy a jewel for the Ephod. And the Gemara says, hold on, this part of the Terumah is the Avnei Shoyham. From there on, you're allowed to buy from a guy. But even that detail came as an issue in the Torah. So the Gemara goes further. And the Gemara says, you solve the problem if you're allowed to take a donation from a guy, a truma from a guy. But the story has a second part to it. The story says that Lashana Acheres, the following year, Hashem didn't want the guy, just because he was nice and honored and respected his parents, to lose this mega business deal. So the following year, Noel Delay Pada Aduma Be'edrei, this Dumba Ben Nissina, in his barn, one of his animals gave birth to Para Aduma. And we know that the Yidden need a Parah Adumah. So the red heifer, the Chachamim hear that there's a Parah Adumah. It's not easy to find. They went back to him, but this time to buy the Parah Adumah. Nichnasu Chachmi Yisrael, actually the Chachamim came to him. Amalem, he says to them, Yoidei Ani Bachem, I know I have you. I know that a Parah Adumah is way too valuable for you, Chachamim. I know that whatever price I'm going to ask you, $10 million, you're going to give it to me because you have no choice. This is what you're looking for. You can't find it. But I am the type of person that I'm not going to get whatever. I'm at least cover my loss from last year. Either the opinion of 60 ribui or 80 ribui, $600,000 or $800,000, that I won. I know I could ask you for much, much more, but I'm going to stick with what I could have made last year. And actually, the Mefarshim, the Gemara say, why is it as a reward for Kibbutz of Aim, the Abish to bless him, that he has a Par Aduma? What's the connection between? And the Mefarshim say that because when he did such great Kibbutz of Aim, there was a Kitrug Mamayla. There was the Malachim were prosecuting the Klal Yisrael. Look, a guy does such Kibbutz of Aim, and Yidden don't do it. So we had to show the Abish set up a system that the Yidden are willing to do a mitzvah and invest money into a mitzvah which has no sense to it. So a Par Aduma is the classical mitzvah which we don't understand, and the Yidden were willing to pay so much more money because the Yidden are much more devoted to Hashem. That was like that's some of the Mefarshim say, it's a vart from the Kutzker Rebbe. Anyways, back to this story. So the Gemara has a Shaila from this story, this part of the story. A carbon? A Par Aduma? You're going to buy from a guy? Do you know how crystal clear, how picture perfect the carbon has to be? And here you trust, you don't have any records of this Par Aduma by the guy. And the Gemara goes on proving how they were able to verify that this Par Aduma is really a pure Par Aduma, doesn't have any hair, doesn't have any black hair, because two black hairs make it. The Gemara goes through that whole process of why you were able to buy it. But there's a beautiful lesson that, if you read between the lines, there's another lesson here. The Gemara says, even once the Par Aduma is born, and you could check it from head to toe and you see it's clean, but there's another problem. Who says its mother was holy? Who says there wasn't any Isser done with the mother? And the Gemara even asks, who says the grandmother, if you could say such a thing by an animal, Isser wasn't done? Because any time Isser is done with a mother, it has a permanent effect on the child. So much so, if the Par Aduma's mother did something wrong, the animal had relationship with a human, with a man or a woman, however it is, it disqualifies not only itself, it disqualifies any offspring it had. We don't have records for that. And the Gemara discusses that. How was he able to buy that carbon? The lesson I'm trying to prove from this Gemara is the Rebbe, in many sichas, said how important it is when a woman is pregnant and she's hoping and praying for the Eibush to bless her with a childbirth of a good healthy kid. So the Rebbe, in many of his letters, says, and he asked, actually instructed, that during the labor, during the pregnancy, the labor and the delivery, there should be a shira milus hanging, and he should have all, and the kid raising the children all around, from the time of the pregnancy, what the mother eats, what the mother thinks, what the mother does, has an effect on the child. We see it in the negative side in the Gemara. The lesson that I want to say is, and the positive side too, that if you invest time, even when there is when you have a child, the parents invest time all the way from the beginning to have the proper mindset and to do only holy matters, it definitely has an effect on the children.